Hi, welcome to my tutorial on injection copies with Cheat Engine, and I'm using Alien vs Predator 2 as a game example. It's an old game, but what the tutorial is about, it's valid with sort of any game or anything that you're doing, and this is just an easy game to sort of hack, and it's pretty straightforward with values and stuff. So this will be part one. There'll be two parts. Part one, this one, it's just going to be sort of simple injection copies, and in part two it'll go a bit more advanced, using scan initializations and stuff, but we'll get to that in part two. So basically, a code injection, well, injection copies, use them just like pointers, but I'd probably say they're more effective. I'd rather use an injection copy than a pointer, for the reason that if, say, you had in your address list in Cheat Engine, you had 10 pointers, all pointing to stuff you wanted to be able to manipulate. If the game was to update or a patch was to come out, probably you'd have to go and re-find every one of the pointers, so it can make it a sort of laborious process. But if you use injection copies, basically all you're doing is copying a base address of a structure, which you can get from an instruction, which I'll show you. And say you had 10 addresses linked to this base address, all you need to do is update your base address, or update the AoB scan to get your base address. So the address that I'm going to be using to find the base, the structure, is going to be the movement type of the player. I'm not going to go into detail about how to find it or whatever. I'm going to assume that you know sort of how to use Cheat Engine. No, I shouldn't have got the armor. I'm going to assume that you know how to use Cheat Engine, and how to sort of filter values and stuff. So if you do want to know how to find these hacks, they are available on the site at sethioz.com/forum, and there's a few topics covering it. But like I said, I'm not going to go into detail about how to find the hacks or whatever, but I know this is the address. So let's just freeze it and double check. And respawn, I should be able to free fly all about the map now. Yeah. Right, so now I've found the address for movement. It's not actually the free fly address, which I know a lot of people called it at the time when these hacks were sort of getting discovered and stuff. A lot of people called it the free fly address, but it's to do with movement type. And if you see the value just now, it's at zero. If I jump, it changes. If I crouch, it changes. If I'm moving, it changes. If I was to go alien and pounce, you see it changes. So obviously, if you had a hotkey to that set to 5, you wouldn't need to wait for the alien to recover before pouncing. But like I said, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about that. So let's just go back to Marine anyway. I get to a place where I want to be. Right, here I'll do. I want to get back up to where I was. Right, anyway, it doesn't matter. Right, so what we want to do is find the base address. So we've got the address for the movement type. So that's the movement type address. So what we're going to do is find the what writes to this address, and yes, to attach the debugger. And when you're in game, do something that'll change the address. So you don't need to go back into free fly, obviously, because we've shown that just moving or anything will change the address. So say there, you see only one instruction has popped up, so we can stop the debugging process now. And if we click on the instruction that popped up and have a look at it, sorry, dissect it a little. If you look in the square brackets here, ECX plus 978. This is what we're wanting. ECX here is the base address, and 978 is the offset, which is basically saying the base address plus 978 bytes, and 978 is in hex, remember. So the base address plus 978 equals the address for the movement type. So ECX, we can find the value for it down here. ECX is 69BBFF0. That's the base address. So let's just copy that for a second, so we've got it copied. Now we'll go show the dissembler. And before you really want to decide that you're using this for getting the base address, you want to when you click the instruction and show the assembler, it should highlight on the instruction that popped up in the memory viewer. So on the instruction, you want to right click it in the memory viewer and find out what addresses this instruction accesses. And now you go back into the game and you do a few things to see if anything else sort of comes up when you're using this. So you want to do a few things just to make sure that that's the only address that that sort of instruction's accessing. And as we can see, it is, which is great, which is exactly what we want. If it accessed more than the one address, then you could run into problems. We probably would run into problems using it to find the base address. So now we know that's fine, we can stop that. And now, as I say, this is part one, so just basic injection copies. All you need to do now is Tools, Auto Assemble, and you can use a template for this, which I'm going to do. So template AoB injection, okay, and Cheat Engine is brilliant at filling in the information for you. But like I say, you can write this down yourself. There is another tutorial on this channel about AoB scans, and it goes through doing it yourself, finding the array of bytes to use. And if you just have a look, 89817809, just have a look for it. There it is, 89817809000, then back to the 89. And it's the module, so you're using this DLL as well. But the template just makes it a lot easier. So all you need to do for the injection copy is add two lines of code, which is a global alloc function, which I'll show you just now. So you're globally allocating, and we're going to call this, just call it base, and then we need to allocate some memory. 4 bytes will be plenty. And then in the code, all you're going to do is add one more line, so the global alloc here is basically allocating memory and registering a label to it globally, so you can use it anywhere within Cheat Engine. So you could search for it in the memory viewer or add it to the address list, which is what we're going to be doing with it, which is sort of the reason for doing this. And the byte to allocate it, 4 bytes, in most cases it'll be enough. I'm not sure if Cheat Engine warns you. I've not actually came into somewhere where it needed more. I've always used 4 for doing this. But if there's a lot addresses I'm using or whatever, I might use 8, but 4 should be enough. So, and this is it. This is how you use injection copy. So it'll scan for this array of bytes, and then it'll jump to its own piece of code and then carry out this. And obviously this is, what I've highlighted here is the original code, so it's not changing the code in any way. All it's doing is copying ECX, the value stored within ECX register, into the value in base. And because we've allocated this, we can use this in the cheat list. So let's close this just now. But the offset was 978, so let's add this to the table. Close it. And now if we execute this script, if we're looking in the memory viewer, if we execute this script, we'll see that it's jumped somewhere, and we can right click and follow, and then you see this is the code we've made. So we're moving the value in ECX into the base, we're moving ECX into the base, which is brilliant. And then we can go back and deactivate it. It should be fine. So how we use this is we go to add address manually and we click the pointer box, and in the pointer address field you type in base or whatever we called the label that we've globally allocated. And for the offset, for the movement address is 978, and then click OK and it'll add to the address list. So this is the movement address. So to show you this working, when you activate the script, It's as soon as that function gets called, the instruction gets called, and it actually happens in game, it's going to copy the base address into base. It's going to copy the base address into base here through this little instruction, and it'll update the table. But it'll only update if you do something in game, obviously, to access this instruction. So all I need to do now is move or jump. And there, you can see in the address list, it's gave me the address that I wanted. And that is basic injection copy. So just to show you that it does work, if I change it to the free fly value and just freeze it, I should be able to free fly everywhere. And so I hope you can see why it's sort of superior to using pointers, where if I had 10 addresses here, all we need to do is update this script, update this AoB scan to find the base, and then all of the addresses, I don't need to go through every single one, which saves a lot of time, and it's great. So let's just turn this off. And that's, well, I think that's part one finished. In part two, I'm going to go into sort of talking about the structures a little bit, because I'm going to be adding more to my injection copy in the address list, and I'm going to be talking about base initialization, scan initializations, and using an update address, where if it's one, or if you choose to update it, it will update, and if it's on no, then you won't update it. But thanks for watching, hope to see you in part two.